Today I'm going to take a look at this 1993 Sonic the Hedgehog piggy bank from the company Happiness Express. Now, he doesn't originally come with these glasses. These are just some Mr. Potato Head glasses that I put on him, and I display him like that because it looks funny to me. This is how he's supposed to look. Now, I ordered this off eBay several years ago, and when I first got him in the mail, my dad said that it looked like Sonic was sitting on the toilet, and yeah, it kind of does. Now, he's actually supposed to be sitting on one of those nuts. See, it's kind of a hexagon shape. It's supposed to be one of those nuts that you run across and it goes up the screw in Sonic 2, which is kind of neat. I think that's what it's supposed to be anyway. It was produced in 1993, so right after Sonic 2 came out in 92. Now, at first glance, the sculpt on this thing is a little weird looking. Like, the face is okay, but like the mouth is a little weird, the nose is kind of stubby, the eyes sort of protrude out of the head in a weird way, and so do the ears. They're kind of like these three-dimensional triangle extruded shapes coming out of the spikes. It's a little strange. Now, the spikes are one of the most curious things about this bank. They're pretty wild looking. I mean, they're really extreme, very different looking from what we're used to seeing now on classic Sonic merchandise, since we kind of know how he's supposed to look in three-dimensional space. Back then, this was produced at a time when in America they didn't really have a very good grasp on what Sonic looked like in three-dimensional space. Japan had it down pretty good. With a lot of their merchandise, they had the proper kind of three-dimensional cone spikes that we're used to seeing on a lot of classic-styled Sonic merchandise today. But in America, there was a lot of stuff like this, and for a long time, it was kind of widely accepted that Sonic spikes were flat, and I guess that's kind of based on the American artwork of the time. They kind of looked flat, and especially in like the Sonic cartoons, like Adventures of Sonic the Hedgehog and the Sad AM cartoon, he had more of kind of a mohawk of spikes. And on toys and three-dimensional figurines of Sonic at the time in America, they often made the spikes like this. So he's got three big rows of four flat spikes. It's cool to see how America tried to interpret Sonic in 3D space before they had very good design documents of what the character would look like from all angles. And it doesn't look bad. I mean, for what it is, as a standalone character model, this is pretty neat. He definitely looks more hedgehoggy than even the real Sonic design, in my opinion. You know, he's got spikes all down the back. There's some examples of other Sonic toys from the time. This McDonald's Sonic, so he's got kind of flat spikes, and it's like he's got three rows of them going down the back. The McDonald's Sonic is from 1993, like this bank, and also from 1993 we have this Dakin Sonic plush, and he's got kind of a similar thing going on with the spikes. Three flat rows of four spikes going down the back. So it was kind of a common thing for American Sonic merchandise back then. Now, Sonic is sculpted with his arms crossed, and here's an interesting detail. The glove cuff on the glove that you can see has the single ringlet, and that's accurate to most of the artwork of Sonic at the time. Back then in the early 90s, Sonic just had single ringlets around the glove cuffs, not double. I think there were a few times in the early 90s where they would draw Sonic with double ringlets, but most of the time it was single ringlets, and that's a detail that's often overlooked in modern classic merchandise today. Like, when you see a toy of classic Sonic made today, they usually use the double ringlet design, like on the Jazzwares figures, the Tomy figures, the first four figures. Even the Sonic Generations version of classic Sonic uses double ringlets around the glove cuffs. And I think that's really interesting, because most of the artwork from the classic era used single ringlets like this. He has a pretty big body, like a lot of the American Sonic the Hedgehog artwork as well. And the shoes are definitely a staple of the American Sonic design. Like, there's no buckles on the side of them. That was usually just a Japanese thing. There were a couple of things made in America, I believe, that did have the buckles on the shoes, but it was rare. And even in Japan, a lot of the times they would leave out the buckles on the shoes in Sonic merchandise. It was just kind of one of those things that's supposed to be there, but most artists, or a lot of artists, ended up neglecting. Really small, thin, pointy, kind of goblin-like shoes, too. I kind of like them. It's kind of funny looking to me. It's kind of hard to see, but he does have a little tail up there on the screw hanging off. Here's the information on the back of it. 1993, Sega, made in China, manufactured by Happiness Express Incorporated. The underside is completely unpainted. It's just the blue plastic that the bank is molded in. And I guess now's a good time to talk about the main feature of this, the bank. Here's the cork on the bottom. It says made in China. You can see mine's pretty mangled down there because it was really hard to get off. I ended up using a knife stupidly to try and pry this away, and it kind of chewed up some of the plastic. Now it comes off real easily. Like when I first got this, it was real hard to pull off, but now comes off a little too easily. Now getting the coins out of this thing is kind of a pain in the egg. The problem is the whole body is hollow and these spikes are hollow, so the coins will get stuck inside the spikes and you have to shake them real hard to get all the coins out. And they'll pile up under here. They'll get caught on this edge around the bottom of the nut, and like it's real hard to get all of them out. There, now he's empty. Now, I don't know if this is difficult on all of them, it's probably just mine, but getting the coins in is pretty difficult because the slot is kind of bent shut. You can see it's kind of squashed there. The slot's right there between the two back spikes, or the two spikes on the top of the head. That's actually a pretty good place to put the slot instead of like right on the top of the head. I actually had this weird dream before I got him because I was wondering where the coin slot was. I had a dream that there was a coin slot right here for some reason. Like, I guess you were giving the coin to Sonic or something. The real coin slot is right here, and it can be kind of hard to get a coin in there. Let's see if I can... You gotta line it up. It's kind of hard to get your fingers in there sometimes, and see, it'll get stuck, so you have to kind of push it down, and I have to pull the spikes apart like that to get the coin to come loose. Now the coin is stuck at the bottom here. It's hard to jingle it out. Now, I used to use this as my actual piggy bank for a little while, and I experienced another problem with it. Because he's a hollow rotocast figurine and it's a little bit flexible, all the weight of the metals from the coins piled up in the head and in the spikes was causing a lot of weight to pull down on these back spikes. And it was squashing him. Like, if I don't know how easy it is to tell, but his butt is kind of sunken into the screw just a little bit, and it's kind of bulging up at the top in between the legs there just a little bit. And while it was being squashed, this middle spike here was touching his tail. So I took a bunch of the coins out of him because I didn't want him to get deformed anymore. It was kind of scary seeing something vintage getting slowly ruined like that, so I took all the coins out. And now I just keep some coins in him, just to help keep him weighted down, because he's pretty light too. He's pretty back heavy, so like just a little tip, he'll fall right over. So having some coins in the base is good to help keep him weighted down. So this is by no means a perfect coin bank for your change. It's just a novelty toy. It's cool to have because it's vintage and it's Sonic the Hedgehog from his early days. I like it a lot. I keep some spare change in there, but I don't keep all the change that I have in there because it would just, it's kind of small. You know, it can warp. It's hard to get the coins out. It's just not very practical. It's more of just a fun thing to have. But I do really like this Sonic bank. It's fun to have. It's fun to put just extra spare change in. Definitely not to fill up all the way because of the warping problem and just the inconvenience of taking out all the change. But it's nice to have. And if you don't want to put spare change in it, you could put like arcade tokens in it or little knickknacks, things like that. It could just be a storage container. Although I wouldn't put anything terribly valuable in it because I don't know what kind of plastic it's made from. It could be acidic and eat through the paint of knickknacks, or it could make metals oxidize. I'm not really sure, but just something to think about. But yeah, I definitely don't use this Sonic bank for all of my change. That honor goes to this little Tykes piggy bank that I've had ever since I was a toddler. It's really sturdy, it's cute, it's big, it holds a lot of change, so I'm probably gonna use it forever. So that's the Sonic Piggy Bank by Happiness Express. I don't think they made any other characters. I think they just made Sonic. I don't think they made Tails or Robotnik or anything. I know they made some banks for other characters, like I think they made Power Rangers and Barney, and they made a couple other just different accessories for popular characters like that. But I believe this is the only Sonic bank there was. So thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed the review, and I'll see you later.